One of the things that's caught my attention, being in South America this time, is to see how much the people love the Lord, and therefore they're so drawn to the prophet. I have seen him changing in the last 10 months. It is as though he's been unleashed. He's free to finally do what he came to earth to do, is my big thing. And also he's free to follow through with things he's been concerned about, but could never do. Now that he's president, he can do those things. I've seen him be able to now do those things that have been in his heart. I've seen him, as I've said, be clearer about doctrine. I've seen him become younger. I've seen him become happier because he's doing what he came to earth to do. So why wouldn't he be happy? He was foreordained to be the prophet of God on the earth today. And when you're finally doing what you said you would do, of course you're going to be happy. I can never talk about the truth that my husband is indeed the Lord's prophet, called by him and instructed by him. I can never even talk about that without choking up. And you know, I can fight tears pretty well. But when it comes to that, when it comes to witnessing about the prophet of the Lord, I feel it deeply every time. It's quite incredible. It catches me off guard. Certainly he has seen the faith of the people. He's seen the love of the people for the Lord. He's seen the love of the people for the temple. That means everything to my husband, to see that, to see them being the people and the missionaries to travel far in order to receive God's word for them. My husband is a global man. I mean, again, he's a techno guy. He's a global mind. He thinks outside of the box. If it's not outside of the box, he's not that interested in it. He's not interested in cutting the ham to fit inside of the pot anymore. Just because it was tradition, man. He's not just about, if it was tradition, let's do something different. It's, let's look at why were we doing that? And that's what has caught his attention over and over again. When he sees things and says, what are we doing that for? What are we spending the widow's mite on that for? He is saying, what really is needful? If we're really preparing the church and the world for the second coming of the Savior, he's sincere about that. He doesn't want us spending money, time, energy on anything that isn't really focused on that. It's pretty stunning. He is only reporting to the Lord, and he is fearless with that focus. That and his passion for preserving the agency of others. This is not a man who will say, you must. In fact, he said to me the other day, I don't even want to use the word must in any of my talks. I don't like that word. The hymn that says, he'll call, persuade, direct, right, and bless with wisdom, love, and light, and blameless ways be good and kind, but never force the human mind, that is Russell Marion Nelson. He will never force the human mind. He loves to have the children stand and sing, I am a child of God. When he says to the parents, teach your children what that really means, yeah, that's a deep, that is loaded. That is loaded. If he really had time, that would take him about 2 hours to unpack what he's really trying to say there, because he is trying to say your body and your spirit are really divine. He's very honoring of the Lord's timing and will say to me, Wendy, with just one shift in the rhythm of the heart, the Lord can get you back. Here's the other thing about him being 94. It does make the rest of us feel badly. When he just gets younger and stronger, if I ever talk about some aspect of my body that isn't working, he'll basically say, isn't that wonderful? Do you see how the Lord is preparing you to come home? Change is always a possibility, especially when you're focused on the Lord. The restored gospel of Jesus Christ is a gospel of change. It's as simple as that. It's all about change. If we're not repenting, if we're not changing every day, then we're not true disciples of Jesus Christ.